because I didn't have any formal training in teaching or coaching, I credit my ideas to my experiences as a player and my own instincts. My coaches have all been males. Why does that matter? Well, here I am trying to be the best female coach that I can be, having only ever played for males. I haven't seen firsthand what that can look like from a female. So today I'm going to speak to you about how gender plays a role in the relationship between an athlete and their coach. A few weeks ago, Serena Williams competed in the U.S. Open. She made headlines for that day. However, it wasn't for winning the U.S. Open, it was for her emotional response to some calls by the officials. She got an early lead, and after started to lose that lead, her coach made hand signals from the audience, and that's illegal, and she was given a warning. A few plays later, she missed a serve, and in frustration, she smashed her racket and received a point penalty. Shortly after that, she was speaking with the officials and got upset and called them a thief and received a game penalty. She made the headlines because she acted in a way that females aren't supposed to act. It didn't fit with the societal norms of being a female. And so looking at the definition of femininity, small, imposing, not imposing, vulnerable, all words that I would not use to describe any successful female athlete. And because she acted the way that she did, she was criticized. The next piece of this is looking at who her coaches were when she was a player. Started off with her dad. Her dad was not a tennis player and actually not a tennis coach, but he was at a country club and heard that tennis players could make money, a lot of money. So he taught himself the game and went on to teach his daughters how to play. There are stories of him using very unconventional methods when it came to coaching. He had them bring their tennis rackets to the court, and instead of using them, he had them throw them as far as they could in an attempt to build arm strength. He hired a boxing coach and had them take boxing lessons in order for them to work on their foot speed. And fast forward up to her coach today. He worked with male tennis players prior to working with Serena. He had a few female tennis players, but most of his experience were with male tennis players. When he was interviewed after the U.S. Open, he was still in the stands, and they came right up to him and they interviewed him and asked him about the hand signals that he gave to Serena. And immediately he said the other coach was doing the same thing too. And then he said that tennis players should be allowed to show emotion, positive or negative. And that's something he's always believed. And then he was asked what he would say to Serena when he got to talk with her afterwards. And he said he wasn't sure because ultimately she played a bad game of tennis. No. I was watching the U.S. Open when this happened, and I saw the interview, and I was shocked because as I was watching it and I saw her eyes filled with tears every time they panned to her face and she was trying to play through it, my heart just broke for her. And I wanted to have my hand on her back and tell her, it's going to be okay, you're going to get through this adversity. I wasn't thinking about her tennis play, and maybe that's because I'm not a tennis coach, but I think that that's the difference between him as a coach and me as a coach. He was looking at the tennis side of her day. So what does it matter that he was thinking that way? Well, male and female coaches are very different. Studies have found that male coaches push their athletes more physically. They're more challenging and more physically demanding. A lot of times they bring their athletes to mental exhaustion, more so than females. Studies have also found that females are more nurturing. They tend to care more about the well-being of their athletes, and they want to develop that personal relationship. So I look at this and I wonder, is the reason why Serena Williams is such a great tennis player because she played for male coaches for her whole life who pushed her more physically than a female coach would have? Or did she have a negative emotional response because she didn't have a female coach? Those are the wrong questions. The right question in my mind is a simple one. It's how do we as coaches affect our athletes? And looking at this list right here, my own life and my own experience as a coach, I found that these aren't always, even though these are my tendencies as a female coach, these aren't always the best things for my players. No. As the nurturing piece of it, female coaches being more nurturing. I found that early on in my coaching career, when I was coaching lacrosse and basketball, same time, so out with my lacrosse team in late January, it's freezing out, and I decided, you know what, we have to end practice early. They looked cold, I felt bad for them, I wanted them to get back focused on their school, we could end practice early. Get back to campus, we're going to have basketball practice in a little bit, and I had two players stick their head in my office, two basketball players stick their head in my office and say, hey, I heard you let lacrosse end early, can we end early today too? And it was. You know, then me realizing that, yes, I ended early for a purpose, but at the same time, what message was I sending to my other teams? When I coach with my husband, he tends to forget to put the water breaks in practice plans. And when I'm there with him, I tend to say, hey, we should probably give him a break. I notice that exhaustion a little bit earlier than he does. There's also times where when he's helping me with our all-girl travel team, where coaches them as if they were the boys, and his coaching is a little more stern and his words are a little more sharp, and it doesn't always get the same effect that he would get with his boys teams. And by no means is his way wrong and my way right. It's just who we are and what our natural instincts are as coaches and how to be, and we have to remember what our players want, not just who we are. Studies show that male athletes want an autocratic approach. They want to be told what to do, and they're going to go do it. They want instruction, and they want to be pushed. Female athletes want more of a democratic approach. They want to be part of the decision-making process and to know the why behind what they're doing. And with crossover that occurs in sports, with males coaching females and females at times coaching males, we need to remember that what our instincts are aren't always what our athletes want. And that's what looking at my husband and I, with the way I coach my players, needs to be more what they want, not just what I naturally do, and the same for him. What athletes need, not just want, is a role model. Role model is defined as a mentor or hero who can be emulated. There's two types of role models, role modeling. The first is role imitation. So that's where you see someone and you mimic their technique or emulate their technique. You see how a baseball player swings the bat or a basketball player shoots a basketball and you emulate that. The second is the comprehensive view. So it's outside their area of expertise. It's mimicking body language, vocabulary, their way of life. Serena Williams was criticized for not being a role model after her behavior at the US Open. Without letting my own nurturing tendencies come in, trying to be as objective as possible, I think that's an unfair statement. I think she was on a big stage, under a lot of pressure, and she herself did not have a great role model. Not taking anything away from her coach, he's done an outstanding job helping her become one of the best, if not the best, women's tennis player in the world. But going back to that interview after the match, he didn't take responsibility for his actions. He said the other coach was doing the same thing too. He was okay that she showed emotion. He said tennis players should be allowed to show emotion. And that made me wonder, is that how he coached? As a coach, did he take responsibility when they were in their practices or ask her to take responsibility for things? And did he ever help her with her emotions, or he felt it was okay for tennis players to show emotion? So he allowed it. I can't pretend that I've been in part of any of those conversations or I know what was said, but that's what stuck out to me when she was criticized for not being a role model. Who was her role model? I think it's important for coaches to realize that we have to be those role models for our players. And that big reason why I'm here today is because one of my players played a big role. role in having this event happen. And it's really not an ideal situation or time in my life to be preparing for something like this. But with everything going on in our season and basketball getting underway, it's important for us as coaches to show that we care about our players. And that even when things aren't always easy for us, you know, what wasn't ideal when I first said yes to my first coaching job, if we get out of our comfort zones and do those things, you know, we're setting that example for our players and showing them that they're more than just athletes for us. By no means am I saying that females should only coach females and that males should only coach males. I think the crossover is great, but as coaches, we need to realize who we are and what our natural instincts are. We need to realize who our players are and what they want and what they think they benefit from the most as players, and then what they need, and that's us being their role models. Thank you.